an historical operation, unprecedented. It's not your usual military operation. Here we rescue and bring home the lost sons of Israel.
Two C-130 Hercules loaded with equipment take off. Operation Solomon is underway. The mission, to bring the remainder of Ethiopian Jewry to Israel. The plane is on its final approach for landing. Down below is the Ethiopian capital, a city surrounded and threatened by rebel forces and controlled by a government on the verge of total collapse. One thing is clear, there is a unique window of opportunity to bring now the 15,000 Ethiopian Jews home to Israel. The mission has to be accomplished from this one takeoff runway and in a very short time.
The people are now gathering around the embassy compound. We notify them in advance and prepare them. In these hours, many more are still arriving. This morning, they were told for the first time that they are going to Israel. They just stood there and stared at us with disbelief.
The buses arrive with the first group. They carry no luggage. Some manage to bring a personal item, a book, a musical instrument, and the expression on their faces is a mixture of confusion and joy. Formerly, all the flights are under the auspices of the Ethiopian National Airlines. This will be symbolized by one flight of this Ethiopian aircraft, which will fly to Israel. The first three aircraft take off, carrying well over 1,000 passengers. Flying time to Israel, 3.5 hours. A convoy of buses brings hundreds and thousands of Jews from the embassy compound to the airport. From now on, every arriving aircraft will be loaded quickly. They endure with great patience and perseverance the hardships and difficulties of this process. The legends have promised them that rescue and redemption will come from heaven, and they will be carried on eagle's wings to Jerusalem. And now finally, the dream has come true. This is a great moment for Uri Luvrani, the man who so competently conducted the protracted negotiations with the Ethiopians. He admits that we couldn't have reached an agreement without the help of the Americans.
It can only be exhilaration. I mean, this is a once-in-a-lifetime event when you see 17,000, roughly, people that are going to their promised land. It's exciting, just tremendously exciting.
Over 1,000 people in this one Boeing 747. On this flight, there are no hot meals, no video films, and no duty-free items for sale. But there is much excitement among the passengers, as well as the El Al crews.
Problem? What are you talking about? This is the greatest thing. Let's make some tzionut and fly home.
The first plane lands, followed by two more. They are bringing the first 1,000 immigrants. A distinguished and excited group of dignitaries and ministers awaits their arrival. But most of the immigrants will not be able to identify members of the cabinet or the opposition party. It will take some time until they'll become familiar with the reality of Israel. Meanwhile, the essence of the complexity and rich variety of Israel is encompassed by one magic word, Jerusalem. The operation is coming to a close. The last group is on its way to Israel. Over 14,000 immigrants have been evacuated from Ethiopia in approximately 36 hours of this operation. The aircraft carrying the command group is going to take off in 15 minutes. One can almost hear a sigh of relief. Tension and concern are replaced by pride joy and elation.
We all had the privilege of taking part in this operation to bring a whole community home. It happens once in a lifetime of a nation.